Welcome back, my peeps. Glad to have you here for another tutorial. Today we're gonna make some cherry pies. Well, my version of cherry pies, maybe somebody else. A Christmas cherry pie. You see that? But anyways, so what's gonna happen here is I'm gonna make the pie a small version of the pie just for the sake of this video. But if you want to, you can do what everything I'm doing on this mini pie, you can do it on a large pie. The same process. It's just that I don't have the time to do this on video. So I'm not making a large one, but I'm going to show you how I made this mini one, which translates easily to this size. You just got to use more product and that's it. Right? So basically, this is a Dollar Tree pie. If you use that big pan, it's definitely a Dollar Tree pie. If you want to get some little tins like this, you can find them anywhere. Or you could buy you a couple of pies from Walmart, eat them, and save the tin. That's up to you. But if not, Hobby Lobby. I got these from Hobby Lobby. They cost $1.99, but if you buy it on the week, there it's 50% off on the baking section. You get it for 99 cents, and there's 12 come in a pack. Of course, I already used up some, but if you don't want to, if you want to make the mini pies like I'm doing and not the Dollar Tree pie. So what are you going to use for these fabulous cherries that's in here? See those cherries? Well, you're going to use this. You're going to get you a couple of bags of these. I made two mini pies with one bag of these, and I still have like about 10 pieces left over. And in this bag, you have three sizes. You have large, medium, and small. You see the little tiny one over in the corner? And that's how you're going to fill in your space to make your cherries, right? So every time I see these, I buy them. I don't care what color they come in. Because let me tell you something. I bought so many of these and I never used it as a vase filler. Ever. But I've used it for so many of them. I used it to make fake candy, fake wrapped candy. I have a tutorial on that. I used it for so many other things, but not to fill a vase. I'll tell you that much. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to open this pack. And when I'm done, I'll put it in this seal pack. Because if you don't, these balls will go everywhere. Y'all know how I feel about foam balls. I don't care if they small, big, they just a pain in the butt. Right? So I'm gonna put that out there. And then I already kind of started, but what you're gonna do, you're basically just gonna glue. Let's keep the cherry pie. I don't know if you can see the cherry pie. I got my snowman right there. Basically, what you're going to do is just fill this up with these balls, right? Let's move this over so you can see what I'm doing. I really have a small space here, but I try to make the best of it. So, look, like right here, like I filled it up. You see right here? Let me put my glue gun down before I burn myself. See that open space? Right there, you're going to look for a medium-sized ball. Let's take a look here. Let's take a look. Here you got the three sizes. You see that? Small, medium, large. I need a medium sized one, and I think it's going to fit right in there. Look. See that? It fits right in there, so I'm just going to glue it down. So you just this is basically going to be like doing a puzzle. You're just going to fit the pieces as best you can. If there's an open spot and you want to put a tiny one, you can, but the first layer, you don't really need to worry about filling in the spots because you're going to go over it and you're going to put more. And that's where you need to worry about filling in like open spaces and open holes. For the most part, try to use the large ones up first. And then you can always fill it up with like a medium-sized one or a small, a tiny one, you know. But you can't put a large one inside of a space that's not going to fit. So use the large ones first. I'm trying to talk fast and be fast. Because y'all know how I feel about videos that take too long. And you don't like it. Not that I don't mind spending time with y'all. But I know y'all don't want to hear me yip yapping. Y'all just want to see the tutorial. And I don't like tutorials that take too long. I just want to do, like, show me the craft so I could go in. Okay, so that's not going to fit. So I need a medium to go there. And then I'm just going to keep going around. And around. You see what I'm doing? Just filling it up. You're going to have plenty of glue strings. Yes, you are. Because this... What can we do about that? Ouch. I'm burning myself. With the hot aluminum tin. Right? So you just keep filling. And then we're going to get in the center. I should have had one finished. So y'all won't have to see me doing this. But I want you to see how it's done. It doesn't take long at all. See right there? Oop. I'm going so fast, I'm not even letting the glue dry. And it's starting to lift up. So let me let that dry for a minute. Look at my cute plate I found at Dollar Tree. Cookies for Santa. This is what we're going to... This is what I'm going to use to make the cookies that we're going to create for Santa. So, leave that right there. Alright, let's try to get rid of some of this glue. Now I'm going to go in the center. Just fill it up best you can. Sometimes you're not going to be able to put it exactly on top of another one because it's going to be too high. And that's okay because you're going to come fill it in with like a medium ball or a small ball. Let me let this set for a minute because it looks like it doesn't want to stick. And we need for it to stick. It got glitter on it, so that might make it a little bit more not as easy to stick because it's trying to stick to glitter. And you know, the glitter is coming off while I'm trying to stick it on there. But we're going to go for it. We're going to go for it. Right? And then I'm gonna show you how to paint it. It's so easy. Ooh, 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 ooh. Hot glue, hot glue, hot glue. All right, let's let that sit for a minute. Look, that worked out. Let me let that glue sit for a minute. And let me take the glue off my hands just because I'm trying to work so fast. Okay, so now we're in the middle of the pie. And I don't think we're going to be able to fit two, but we could fit one and a medium-sized one right there. Okay, this glue is not cooperating. It's still warm. Oh, Lord. Look at this. You know what? I done did this like 3 times. And that, the glue ball sticking to me and all of that, it ain't never happened. As soon as I record this video, they act up. I tell you. But that's all right, because I'm going to let them get their way. Okay. So, for the most part, it's filled up. But you see, there's a little couple of empty spaces. And we're going to go in there and we're going to put some tiny balls in there. Or medium-sized one. Because some of the medium-sized balls fit. Like I said, it's like working a puzzle. You just got to go in. Try to stuff it in there. Best you can. Hold it down if you need to. Because like I said, the glue gun and glitter, it really don't want to work together. But it will. It will stick together. Just gotta give it some time. So I'm going to stick some of these little ones all over the place, and then I'm gonna show y'all how it looks after. When you see the little balls, they just filling up spaces. That's all they're doing, filling up little spaces. So when you put your crust on, you won't see no space, you know. This is pretty easy. You just gotta fill it up. Probably the most hard part is gonna be the crust. Y'all know I ain't good at no crust. But I'm gonna try. Let me see if a medium one fits in here. Yep, it does. So let's let that dry for a minute, because I don't want it to come apart. Take some of this glue web off. So then I'm going to go in here and just stick a little one in there. So it take. Oh my. Like, why y'all acting crazy right now? Can't you see we got company? Like, for real. Alright. Anyway, so I'm going to move on to the next step. I think we pretty filled. This glue. I think we pretty filled up. You see that? I mean, you could fill it up more if you want, but for the sake of this video, I'm going to move on so y'all can see the next step. But I'm going to let this dry a minute, because I don't want the glue to be wet and then, I mean, not set and it move around. So let's let that sit. I'm going to put my balls away because we're not going to need them after this. Let me do it like this because I can see them going all on the floor, and I ain't in the mood for them right now. I'm gonna put these in here. I mean, I could have just kept them in the bag, but it's hard to reach for them and hot glue, and then the glue get cold by the time I stick the ball on. So trust me, I already tried that. All right, so here we go. These could go away. We don't need them anymore, but look. See, you still have enough to make a mini pie if you want. Like for the large pie pan, I suggest you get like 3 bags of this, just to be sure that you have enough, because it might not be enough. You know, just to be sure, you can always save them and use it for something else. So hold on a second, because I'm gonna try to get rid of some of these glue. I know somebody said use a hair dryer and it takes away, but honestly, I don't have time for that. I mean, I could have got my heat gun real quick, but that's a tip somebody gave me, that if you take your hair dryer or one of those heat guns and hit it, the spider webs disappear. Okay, that's good. So you're gonna paint it. You can use acrylic paint like Apple Barrel or whatever, but you're probably gonna have to use probably 2 or 3 coats to get over that glitter. So, but I'm gonna use this Liquitex. It's called Cadmium Red Deep Hue. I'll link it down below so you could get it from Amazon if you want, but they have this in you get it at Michael's. You can get it at Hobby Lobby. You can get it at, I never seen it at Joann's or Walmart. But I'm not saying they don't have it. I just never looked at it. But I did look Michael's and Walmart's. I mean, Michael's and Amazon do have it. So you can get that. It's a very thick. Look how thick that is. You see? I don't know if you can see. How thick? It's very thick. It's like, you know, acrylic, Apple Barrel acrylic paint is, it's like a little bit watered down. This is artist grade paint. Like, artists use this paint. But anyways, enough about that. But I want to show you how fast it covers the gold. This is what I wanted to show you. Like, how the color goes on so fast. It just covers up that gold. like really fast, and you could just move on. You don't probably, I didn't use two. I just used one coat. I really did just use one coat. I didn't go back. Because, you know, it's going to be covered with crust anyways. But you do want to make sure you get into all those little cracks and crevices. You don't want to see that through your pie. But you see how good that's covering that up? Look at that other side. And look at the side I just painted. You see how good that's covering it up? It does a really good job. That's why I suggest this paint. You don't have to use it. You use what you have. You have apple barrel red. You use apple barrel red. That's what you use. You don't have to buy anything extra. All right. So I'm going to move up. I have one that's already painted, you know. I'm going to use up the last bit of this paint, though. Can't let that go to waste. Because that, you know, it's not the same price as apple barrel paint. So you got to make sure that you use it. Get in them corners. All right, I used up the little bit of that paint. I didn't get a chance to paint everything. I'll paint it after I finish with you guys, okay? All right. So we don't need this anymore. I have this now. See it? It looks pretty good. It has some couple of open spaces, and that's all right. I'm not even gonna worry about that because that's down at the bottom. We're gonna make the crust. Crust. You see this crust? I think I made it too thick. Like, you can't even really see the cherries. I mean, is it, that's the way it's supposed to be, right? Or is it, I don't know. I don't know nothing about pies. This is my third pie ever made, but it was fake. Never made real pie. And I could hardly barely make fake pie. But, you know, we're going to go for it. So, we're going to make a crush, and then that's it. And then you could go make you one, too. And you could get everything you need from Dollar Tree. I went to Dollar Tree this week, and I saw that they had these. They had this in red, yellow, blue, and white. So if you see it, pick it up. You know, it's a dollar. You don't get a lot for a dollar, but it'll be enough to help you do a couple of projects. I mean, unless you order it on Amazon, or you want to get a big bulk one for $25 from like Joann's or Walmart or whoever. And if you just want to try out Model Magic, that's a great time to get it. I love Model Magic. I use it a lot. Crayola should be sponsoring me for all this Model Magic stuff I've been making, but that's another story. All right, so here we go. And the color I used, right, I took some white Model Magic, and I just added some brown paint to it. That's all I did. You know what? I'm going to cut. Oh, you're going to need a pizza cutter. I'm going to just cut this in half because I don't think I need this whole piece right now, because you're going to cut it out pretty thin. I didn't even bring my paint stirrers like I usually do, so I could get the right, you know, size. You just want to do them pretty thin, like a real pie crust. So what I'm gonna do, right, I'm gonna, okay, y'all, stop acting crazy. I'm just gonna cut like straight lines just so it could help me, and cut this one straight. Make sure you keep your Model Magic covered, because it gets hard if you don't. And this right here is a little crooked, so I'm just going to cut it straight. You could get you a pizza cutter at Dollar Tree. Uh-huh. Yes, you can. And use it. Keep it for your crafting. Do not, once you use it for crafting, you're not going to use it for eating. So I'm going to try to cut these strips a little thinner than I did the last batch. Okay. See if we can see the cherries through the... So through the strips. Do not let those pieces touch, because once they touch, they become one. So, okay, that's enough to get us across to the first layer. So you're just gonna go across. Let's start in the middle. And all I did was, I'm just gonna push it down. I'm not gonna put no hot glue. I'm not gonna do none of that. Just do that. See what I did? I just pushed it down and pinched it into the lip of the pie crust. Then I'm gonna go on the other side, do the same thing. Just push it down. If you feel you need to put hot glue, by all means, go on ahead and do that. See me? I just did it. Okay. Why do I want to keep sticking to my hand? Okay, that's the second one. Put your pieces in a container. Gotta save it because you gotta make crust to go the other way. So you gotta save all your little pieces. There you go. That glue on my finger is getting on my nerves. And then you're going to go down to the edge. Right? I think I could have. Oh, man. There go that daggone glue from the glue gun. You think that's good? Or should I do another strip? Because I'm already kind of close to the edge. It's not going to look right. So let's just go this way. And if we got to add, I told you I ain't never made no pie. This one going to keep moving. All right, hold on. Oh, Lord, this is what I don't like about my, I love Model Magic, but I don't like that when it touches another piece that hasn't dried yet, they stick together. Like I said, they become one. All right, so now we got to roll out a couple more pieces because I don't have enough. Make sure you stretch out your Model Magic real good. You know, you got to condition it, stretch it. All right, let's go. I'm gonna cut a piece off. I don't think I need that whole big piece. Just roll it. And if you were ever looking for this is actually a polymer clay roller. So if you ever wanted to get one, you could get one from like in the clay section. Ouch. See, I burned myself. In the clay section of Michael's, Joann's, any one of those, they'll have it. Hobby Lobby. It don't cost that much. It costs about like $3. I had those for a long time. I've been into every type of craft you could think of. I've been crafting forever and a day. I used to craft with my mom. So I've been crafting for years. If you should see my craft room, it got like every type of freaking craft you could think of. Wood crafting, been there, done that. Polymer clay, been there, done that. Jewelry, I got beads and jewelry findings. I got, oh, whew. Trust me. Ask me, I might have it. For real. And I have some stuff from like many years ago, from back in the day, the 80s, the 90s. I keep my craft supplies, honey. I've been throwing away and giving away a lot of stuff. Never craft supplies, I can tell you that much. All right, so let's see, because I want the cherries to show. So I don't want the strips to be too big. Let's see. Okay, that looks good. I'm not being fancy. You know how some people do that up, down, up, downs, underneath and lifted. No. I can't be that fancy. First of all, with Model Magic, that's impossible because you, once you put it down, you're not going to lift it up because it's already stuck to the other part. Let's use this one. A little skinnier. Okay. We got our crust on. Now we're going to go around. See that? Can you see it? Now we're going to go around and make a crust to go on the edge. And we are done with this pie. And you can go on and make you some pies too. Yes, you can. Very easy. Okay. Gotta roll this out again. Oh, no. I don't need to roll this out. I could just, I think this is enough to roll out. Just gotta get all this glue. I don't want to pick up no glue or dust from those fake cherries we made. So, like for the next month, so for the month of December, I'm going to try to drop a couple of extra tutorials. I just want to thank you guys for supporting me and helping my channel grow. And, done messed with the daggone cherry, a chocolate chip snowman. I keep calling him a snowman. He not a snowman. He a marshmallow. Just remind me of a snowman. He could be, right? Alright, I think this is long enough to go around, but just in case, let me stretch it a little bit more. I think that's good. So make sure your edge is not bent. Make sure you got all your pieces down. Because like I said, once this Model Magic touches, they are one. So I'm just going to go around the pie. And cut that piece off. Not gonna look pretty right there, but that's okay. Now make sure you get your clay down real good, like to the edge of the pie pan, right? See that? You can leave it like that. Yeah, I know I ain't no pie expert, but I'm just gonna do this because that's all I can do. Just pinch it and give it that look of a fancy crust. But I can't make no fancy crust. So, that's my fancy crust. That's it. And there goes your pie. I like the mini pies. You could put these on your tier trays. Do whatever you want. You could, if you want, you could put a little some whipped cream and get a little festive with some holly leaf and berries. You do whatever you want. So guys, that wasn't too hard. That was pretty easy. It's cheap. Like I said, you can find everything at Dollar Tree or Hobby Lobby for a very cheap, reasonable price. And like I said, you those berries, whenever you see them, you buy them because you can do so much with them. Anyway, guys, until the next video, stay safe, healthy, and crafty. And if you can, I will love it if you subscribe to my channel, leave me a comment. And also, if you belong to a crafting group or if you have a group, and you would like to share my videos, I would really love that so much. Thank you guys. Oh, you know what? Before I leave, I forgot to say, before you put the crust on, if you want to take some Mod Podge and like the glossy Mod Podge, because I did that on this one. I forgot to tell you that. That's why it looks a little shiny. Because I put the glossy Mod Podge on the cherries and let that dry. You gotta let it dry real good. Do not put the crust on there. Try to put the crust on while that's wet. It's not gonna be good. So if you wanted to do that, you could do that. And you can see that the cherries will be glossy inside. I'm sorry I forgot that part. But I was just trying to be quick, of course, you know. But anyway, guys, again, stay safe, healthy, and crafty. And I'll talk to you guys again next time. God bless you.